together the two roles in private law, the responsibility and the restitution. And since we are going to talk so much about restitution and cultural restitution in the next 2 days, I was wondering whether you can begin to differentiate them a little more. For example, in terms of period, for example, maybe restitution is better after the people die and we have the objects to keep on dealing with them. Maybe it's different with societies or with groups that cherish private property as opposed to groups that cherish other ways of organization. Is there a danger in restitution as opposed to injuries? I just want to open up the map to see maybe they go in different directions. Maybe they are not.
It's a very good question, and quite honestly, I feel like I have a better handle on how the responsibility claims mm-hmm. have evolved and how the different sort of influences and sources from international law and the remedial influences have kind of come in. So I feel I have a better handle at this point on those claims. The other thing I'd say about the restitution claims is that there's a huge difference, as you pointed to, that the varieties of so-called property. We've wondered what to, with our conference, we haven't been able to figure out what the right general term is, you know, property, objects. Part of the reason I say that is that for Indigenous people, a lot of the property is their ancestors. It's human remains, and so using the language of property and objects to get the return of ancestors is very, very troubling. And then the spectrum from wildly valuable pieces of art, let's say, that generate their own kind of distortions, I would say, and you've written about this in the issues of cultural property. I think that those may be more complex than the interests at stake in the responsibility claims, because the responsibility claims at the end of the day are about the inherent value of the human person and the harm to autonomy and the ability to live a good life. And I think you pointed to this, there's definitely a natural law twist to how I'm thinking about this, and I think that you know, that sort of very powerful idea drives the responsibility claims, but is much more complex in the restitution claims, especially if you also consider slave labor as unjust enrichment and for a restitutionary remedy. So those I do feel are more complicated, and I don't feel I have as good a grasp on them, which is not to say I have a really great grasp on all the others.
I think we will all have a much better grasp on them.
Yeah, we
in
will.
2 days
yeah,
from
that's
now.
Right. We will.
So unless somebody still wants to ask, so we finish for today. We thank our two speakers and we'll